Watch it. They get you sitting again. You'll feel it this time.
You watch it. I can't take the smell. If he won't eat it, then I will.
Every day with this, it's his food. If he doesn't want it, it's not our business. It is my job to give it to him and make sure it's for him only.
What about the flies? I don't see you harassing the flies. Oh, I guess the flies are exempt. Royal flies, eat what you want. But the starving Abbas, who works for his keep, isn't allowed a
shippy.
Idiot! Our shift is almost over. Can we just get through this last hour?
Fine by me. I don't like or enjoy your company anyway. We never socialized outside of these walls. To tell you the truth, I find you always smell of mildew. There, I said it.
Enough!
Well, now you did it! Who would want to eat chickpea smoosh by your smelly boot, huh?
You help me clean this up.
You go ahead and clean up the holy man's not eating food. It must be nice to be able to refuse food. What a luxury. What a sham he is, I say. A hypocrite. What's the word, guys?
Hypocrite.
Try refusing food when you're begging in the streets like I did before I joined the guard. Your holy ideas go out the window when faced with starvation. Why wouldn't he just eat? You know, if I came upon him when I was eating out of rubbish bins, he wouldn't last the night with this talk of God. I'd rob him of everything. The nice pancake.
Shut up! Do you care? This man's friends have been slaughtered all over the country. Dragged through the streets. Beheaded.
I was in one of those details.
You were?
A miserable slaughter.
You never mentioned that before.
This is something you mention.
And your heart doesn't move? That he cries through the night, every night, about his friends? He begs his God. He writes tirelessly to his God. Have you ever listened to him pray?
I'd rather listen to the flies buzz. Look, they're happy now. At least someone's getting fed. We fed the flies. I think you take this job a little too seriously, Ghazi.
I do.
You know, a dummy could do what we do?
That's right. So I'm looking at one right now. You blinked.
I won.
What do you care about this Bob, Ghazi? Huh? I never known you to be a believer in anything but the rules. slicked back hair. Your uniform all buttoned and mended. You sure could use a little shower, I tell you that.
I don't smell a boss. It's your own scent. The dog knows his own. I'm not a believer in a god or what have you. It's too much suffering. But I have seen the townspeople gather. Catch a glimpse of the Bob. I've seen them wait in long lines, the public bath, to be the first to climb into his bathwater, hoping it will heal them. I've seen love and hope in the people's eyes as he takes his daily walk through the yard. I've seen his grief.
Stand up to a fist, you get punched. So I don't. You should try ducking next time, Ghazi.
What do you know?
Are you crying?
No.
You are crying.
I'm not.
Let me see.
No.
Let me see. No. I'm not crying. Oh, I'm not crying, no.
You shut it! Thank you. You know, the Bob speaks of men and women the same. No beatings. No slavery. They are the same. You understand?
Don't tell my wife this. She will want to sit all the time. She will want to show her face to everybody. I'd sooner cut my neck off than watch that happen.
Yeah, imagine women doing what we do.
Ha! They will want to sit around all the time and talk about girly things like clothing.
Yeah, and beatings.
Mm. And cooking.
Suffering.
See, Ghazi, that is why this man is really locked up here. Nobody wants that. What good is all that talk? You don't change anything. There's an order we follow. You can't change that.
Maybe you can. Maybe you should.
Good luck trying. Look what happened to the Buzz friends. Huh? They sacrificed them like goats in the streets.
Did you do such a thing?
We marched far toward a fort filled with bobbies. Everyone talked about how treasonous the teachings were. How this man, the Bob, was poisoning our society. I started to fill with rage myself. I wanted to stomp them out. I wanted to fight men. I entered the fort right behind the first line of soldiers. The order to fire was called. I couldn't really see anything yet. The first line of soldiers kneeled down. I raised my rifle. And I saw only mothers and children standing stone still, brave, arm in arm. Yet I fired. A woman fell to the ground. I don't know if it was me that hit her. It didn't matter. After the smoke cleared, they were all dying. Every last one. I walked to the woman. Her veil had come off. And I saw her face was filled with this peaceful joy I'd never seen in someone dying. No suffering, no begging for life, just peace. I think about that woman a lot. And what I did. They were killed to keep things the same. I killed. The Bob is making people change. So they send him to this filthy hole in the side of a mountain to rot.
Do you want a change? What would you change?
Nothing.
There must be something.
I want a silk hat.
Really?
Another wife? Food. Like what the Shah eats. You know, my baby girl, she's hungry all the time.
Must be a joy to have a child.
Yeah, well. She won't learn how to read. She won't be able to go to school. She will end up fighting with men over a cold plate of food, without a voice, beaten by her husband. And the mullahs talk about God and Muhammad. what they do to the bomb. What do you think?
I hear they will execute him.
I won't be doing that.
What do you mean?
I won't be doing that, I said.
What? Wow. Big tough of us. Won't be killing the holy man?
No. No.
You would disobey an order.
I don't believe in killing this man.
What?
You heard me?
Why?
I don't know. Something in me I can't put my finger on. I try to wrap my mind around it, but it's a strong feeling, like wanting to hold your daughter at night. I've heard him say, "I beg thee to forgive me for every mention but the mention of thee. Whoever would implore such a thing, I'm not put into their death. I would never beg for such a thing, for such a silly thing. I mentioned so many things I'd rather have before God, like bread and wine, a woman, a bed, a happy child, sunrise over the mountains, peace in the valley, a chicken, a mother, a friend, a chickpea. Anyways, I will run if they ask me to do that.
And I will run with you.
He only speaks of love. Divine breeze blowing through the trees. He never hurt anyone. Who are they to decide?
Let us decide.
Let us.
He will probably shoot us as well.
Yeah, probably.
Please, eat this.
Eat, please.
You must eat.
For Roya, my daughter.
For me.
You may be a prisoner.
I feel you can set us free.